Hello， 弟兄姊妹们平安，欢迎大家参加线上联合崇拜。Good morning, brother and sister. Welcome to join our online combined service. 诗篇四十七篇一到二节如此说：万民啊，你们都要拍掌，要用跨声的声音向神呼喊，因为耶和华至高者是可畏的，他是治理全地的大君王。英文如此说 ：Clap your hands, all you nation.Shout to God with cries of joy, for the Lord Most High is awesome, the great King over all the earth. 现在我们一起来敬拜我们的神，让我们一起起立。Let us rise and praise the Lord together.
Hallelujah, Hallelujah. 天父，我们来敬拜你。耶稣，我们高举你的名，圣灵，我们欢迎你在我们当中自由的运行。
Yes, we welcome you.
因为你配的，你配的，你配的。
You are worthy.
Holy, holy, holy.
Amen.
You are worthy to be praised. We want to lift your name on high. We want to sing this song to lift your name on high. Jesus, we enthrone you. 耶稣，我们尊崇你。耶稣，我们尊崇你，齐宣扬你作王，主求你与我们同在，我们要赞美侍奉你。沙漠中开江河，在旷野中开道路的神，我们仰望你，你在我们当中，你在我们当中，
你同在，充满在这里，我敬拜你，我敬拜你，你同在。心在这里，我敬拜你，我 敬拜你。
You are here.
My Savior God
在天上的父，你是配得我们敬拜的神。主啊，我们要用我们的灵来向你歌唱。在这期间，无论有多大的挑战、多大的恐惧、多大的不安，都不能够阻止我们有一颗愿意向你敞开、向你发出赞美声音的神灵跟心。主啊，你帮助我们，让我们能够用赞美来面对一切。我们要用赞美来去面对困境，我们要用赞美来面对恐惧，我们要用赞美来面对所有生活当中所要面对的挑战和挣扎。主啊，你是创造我们的神，你是爱我们的神，求你继续的来指引我们，来帮助我们，让我们能够在这期间能够继续的以你为我们的领导，以你为我们的老师，以你为我们的元帅，好让我们生活的每一个步伐、每一个的决定、每一天的生活都能够依然的跟你保持着美好的连结，来回应这时代的需要。希望今天我们能够在线上一起的来敬拜，这都是你的恩典，求你祝福这次的线上崇拜。在我们当中有英文堂、有中文堂、有不同的弟兄姊妹们，在我们当中，主啊，我奉的名求你超越空间的大能时刻彰显在我们当中，透过网络进入到我们生命里面，让我们在家中、在房间、在车、在任何一个地方，我们都能够经历到神你大能的同在。主啊，问题虽大，但是只要有你的同在，你会帮助保护我们胜过所有的死因幽谷。主啊，求你使用我们今早的这个线上崇拜，我们要特别为这今早的讲员莫泽川牧师来向神你祷告。主啊，你祝福牧师，你恩膏牧师的口，让他口中所释放的话语带着安慰、带着能力、带着鼓励，让他透过从你所领受的话语释放在这个线上聚会的时候，每个参加在当中的都要经历到神你亲自的造访，神你亲自的在他们生命当中来对他们说话。主啊，谢谢你，我们将整个的聚会都完全交在你的手中，愿你牵引，愿你保护，将一切的荣耀都归于你。主啊，我们此刻用你所教导我们的祷告来向你祷告， 我们在天上的父，愿人都尊父的名为圣，愿父的国降临，愿父的旨意行在地上，如同行在天上。我们日用的饮食，今日赐给我们，免我们的债，如同我们免了人的债，不叫我们遇见试探，救我们脱离凶恶。因为国度、权柄、荣耀，全是父的，直到永远。阿们。接下来，我们用使徒信经来宣告，坚定我们的信仰。我信上帝，全能的父，创造天地的主。我信我主耶稣基督，上帝的独生子，因圣灵感孕，由童贞女玛利亚所生，在本丢皮拉多手下受死、埋葬、复活、升天，坐在全能父上帝的右边，将来必从那里降临，审判活人死人。我信圣灵，我信圣而公之教会，我信圣徒相通，我信罪的赦免，我信身体复活，我信永生。阿们。弟兄姐妹们，请坐。接下来我们要来看今天的经文。今天的经文取自马太福音11章28到30节。我先用中文来为大家念。凡劳苦担重担的人，可以到我这里来，我就使你们得安息。我心里柔和谦卑，你们当负我的轭，学我的样式，这样你们心里就必得享安息。因为我的轭是容易的，我的担子是轻省的。 Today's scripture is taken from Gospel of Matthew chapter 11 verses 28 until 30. Come to me, all you who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your soul. 现在我们把时间交给我们的主理牧师莫哲传牧师来带给我们分享。 We pass the time to Reverend Bo.
主内弟兄姐妹们平安，我们感谢神带领我们再一次经过了一个星期到他面前来敬拜主。
Peace be with you, brothers and sisters in Christ. We thank the Lord that we are able to worship the Lord.
今天我要跟大家分享的这个题目是担子太重。
The title of my message this morning is Heavy Laden.
相信大家最近我们谈的这个话题八九不离十，都是劳作我国最近新冠肺炎忽然间确诊的人数增加的问题，我们都在那里一直转。
I believe that our current hottest topic that we are talking about is about the numbers of the coronavirus cases that are happening in our country.
我们每个人的心情都会随着每日这个卫生部他们的报告的数字上上下下起起落落，忐忑不安。
And it feels like our emotion is going on a roller coaster ride when we listen about the cases going up and down each day.
这个确诊人数的反弹好像不是单单在我国，在整个亚洲都是如此。
Even the newly arising cases for each day is not only happening in Malaysia, but also in other countries.
在泰国季增能够有一天增加到八九千个人。
Even in Thailand, they have an increase of 8,000 to 9,000 cases per day.
那这个台湾本来也是没有的，突然间一天增加了好几百宗。
And even in Taiwan, they have an increase of 100over cases per day.
新加坡是被公认世界公认为防疫最好的国家，但是近来大家都看到了他们的本土确诊可以从十多宗也有20多宗也有到30多宗。
Even for Singapore, one of the best healthcare or the prevention measures that have been taken, they have local cases that are rising as well.
那根据经济啊，这个新加坡它的新闻的报道的里面，我们看到近来要去寻求这个心理医生帮助的这些病患增加了大概50%。
Even according to the news report in Singapore, recently there have been an increase of 50% over people who are seeing the psychiatrist.
那接下来我们的问题可多了，在这个 FMCO, full MCO 的里面，它影响了我们的生活的习惯，比方说我们的休闲啊、社交活动啊、运动啊、 那么也影响了我国的经济。
So we know with the current FMCO, we are really affected in our everyday lives, recreational activities, even in our social relationships, our finances, and especially those who are working.
你看这些工作的上班族，他们也很苦啊，因为他们不晓得要带什么信，他们才可以啊到另外一个地方来上班。
Even for those who are working, they don't know which letter or which approval that they need to get from in order to go to work.
那我们教会面对什么问题呢？崇拜， so, 面对一路我们要一路崇拜的视频，还有崇拜的这些 SOB， 我们也是在那边团团转。
And even for the churches, we face a challenge whereby we have to pre-record our services and which SOP are we to follow?
我们是要根据中央政府的呢？还是区域的这个政府的呢？还是地方的官员给我们的指示？他们各有所持。
So which instructions should we follow, taking orders from the different local authorities? Which one is true?
那有时坦白说，搞到我们真的是在那里团团转，而且呢不知所措。好彩，我一直告诉我自己，稍安勿躁。
And he has caused us so much confusion. But praise be to the Lord, I tell myself, be still.
在我的家庭的里面，家庭往往就是我们的这一个避难所，也是我们其中的支柱，其中一个支柱。
And even in our family, even at this time, although we are affected, but family remains the pillar of our strength.
我的女儿发来的这个信息，这个短信震撼时宜。她说 ，You have tried your best effort. I think you can leave the rest to God.
My daughter sent me this text saying that, 你已经尽力而为了，我相信你可以交托其余的给上帝。
上个星期在做礼拜的时候
，Last Sunday, even as we were attending the Sunday service,
当我们在思考接下来的星期要怎么做的时候，我很感谢神，神就赐下这一句话给我帮助。凡劳苦担重担的人，可以到我这里来，我就使你们得安息。
When I was thinking about how are we to proceed with our Sunday services, God gave me this very word. Come to me, all you who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest.
那我们就问，什么劳苦，什么重担？
So what is the heavy laden? What is the burden that you have?
那这里他提到了这个轭，其实轭是套在牛背上，那个沉重用木制的这个器具，它是要跟牛拉动后面的这一个拉车，牛拉车的器具，它是连在一起的。
When we talk about the yoke, it is the wooden instrument that is locked onto the cow's neck, and also as well, it's a conjoining tool that joins together with the burden that he has to carry.
那我在这里就一直思考，当耶稣讲这个经文的时候，其实我们人啊。都背负着许多的轭，许多的重担。这担子可能是来自我们生活当中的，可能是我们工作方面的，也可能是宗教方面的，还有病痛的，或者我们的欲望的，还有有时我们被罪恶所困，这些都可以成为我们的轭。
When Jesus talked about the burden or the bondage that we have, it could come from our everyday life, our work.Even religious beliefs, our sickness, or even our own desires, or being even in bondage of sin.
那你来看看一下犹太人的轭是什么？若从这个犹太宗教背景来说，就是拉比把上帝给我们把上帝赐给我们的律法的这一些的东西，他们加了他们的注解。比方说，拉比把这些信仰呢，就变成了仪规，变成了教条。吃饭前一定要洗手啦，还有安息日是不能够工作啦，连救人都不能。
So how do the Jews understand this word yoke? Actually, for the rabbis, they have added many other instructions towards the rules and regulations besides the law that they have to keep. It's, for example, like they have to wash their hands before eating. They cannot work on a Sabbath day.
那有一天耶稣跟门徒在安息日，有一天那天刚好是安息日，经过麦地的时候，门徒的肚子饿了嘛，就顺便啊抓了一把的这一个麦穗，抓这个麦穗来吃。法利赛人怎么讲？他对耶稣说，你的门徒做了安息日不能够做的事。
And even on a Sabbath day, one day when they were going through the wheat fields, and the disciples were hungry, and they actually began to just pluck off to have some food. And the Pharisees began to say, what are you doing? Today is Sabbath. Why are you working?
那耶稣就回答他们说，圣经有记载，大卫跟他跟从的人在肚子饿的时候所做的事，你们没有读过吗？没有念过这个经文吗？他怎么进到圣殿里面？他吃了陈设饼，圣殿的这个陈设饼，这个饼不是大卫，耶稣说的，不是大卫跟他跟从他的人可以吃的，唯独只有祭司才可以吃的。
How did Jesus reply? Jesus said, "Haven't you read what David did?" When he and his companions were hungry, he entered the house of God, and he and his companions ate the consecrated bread, which was not lawful for David and his companions to do so, but only for the priests.
那耶稣离开那个地方，他进了一个会堂，那里刚好有一个人，他有孤干的一只手，那么有人就故意要为难耶稣，来问耶稣说，安息日治病可以？或者不可以，他们想找机会来控告耶稣。
And going on from that place, Jesus went into their synagogue, and a man was with a shriveled hand was there, looking for a reason to bring charges against Jesus. They asked him, "Is it lawful to heal on the Sabbath day?"
那耶稣说，你们中间，请问你们中间，如果谁有一只羊？在安息日，听清楚啊！安息日掉在坑里，你们不会去把它救出来，把它抓起来的吗
？And Jesus answered to them, saying, "If any one of you has a sheep and it falls into a pit on a Sabbath day, now on the rest day, will you not take hold of it and lift it out? How much more valuable?"
那耶稣说，我们人的生命啊，是比羊来的更贵重的，所以安息日做善事是可以的。
So how much more valuable is a person than a sheep? Therefore, it is lawful to do good even on the Sabbath.
你看到吗？这个犹太人的信仰的当中，那么我们如果用自己的话来注解这一些的律法，可能我们都给别人这个信仰、宗教，还有这个礼仪这一方面的恶。
So the way that the Jews keep the law, they have added so many other rules and regulations, and perhaps we have also added burden upon burden on ourselves.
那这段经文的里面，就是马太福音第十一章二十八到三十节的经文的里面，他提到耶稣的恶是容易的，也是轻省的。
And in the book of Matthew, chapter 11, verse 28,It talks about the yoke of Jesus is easy and it's light to bear.
那耶稣并不是要呼召我们成为门徒，所以他就放低了他自己的水准，或者放低了他自己的要求，不是，乃是这位科目啊，这位科目，我们跟他建立关系的主，他很愿意在我们的日常生活的当中帮助我们，跟我们同行。
When Jesus mentioned that the yoke is easy and light, he is not actually lowering his requirement towards his disciples, but he is actually giving out an invitation. He desires to have a relationship where we can build together with him and we walk together with him.
那我们就问一下，在我们生活的圈子的里面，我们来鉴定一下，什么人是劳苦担重担的人？
So in our lives, we need to ask ourselves, who are those who are heavy laden people?
是你吗？
Is it you?
是我吗？
Is it me?
那可能第一批的人还是宗教人士，宗教这方面的。
And perhaps the first group of people could be the religious group leaders or people.
你在努力不懈的要在祭功德，你要做好事，你想借助你的善行来寻求一些的解脱。
Perhaps you are striving so hard so that you can earn good merit points so that you can be blessed after death.
也可能你想借助一些好的表现来讨上帝的喜悦。请问弟兄姐妹们，在你的生活当中，你这样的努力是不是有时你觉得很累了？因为你好像连自己都不满足自己，你达不到这个标准。
Perhaps you are trying to perform so well so that you can gain favor from God.Aren't you tired?
你这个轭很重哦。
And this yoke that you have borne is so heavy.
记得圣经里面说，只要口里承认，心里相信，就可以得救。不要再负你那个不能够负的轭。
But remember what the word of God says, that as long as your mouth confess, as long as you believe unto the heart, so do not keep holding on to this yoke.
那有一些人他们可能是被这个罪所捆绑压伤的。
And some of us are still in the bondage of sin.
所以罪恶把你压伤，你觉得很辛苦。为什么你今天不来到神的面前，把你这些的问题卸给他，让他来帮助你呢？
We are caged up by sin, but why don't we just lay down before God and ask God to help and deliver us?
有一些人为了名义、地位。权势所困。
There are some people who are bonded by fame, status, and power.
那这一切，其实当你围着名义、地位这些权势所困的时候，这一切的一切，最终都会换来的是虚空的虚空。
And the outcome of all these things are just vanity of vanities.
亲爱的朋友，如果你是这样的人，最终你会发现到你没有真心朋友的，有时你会很孤单的，因为跟你亲近的人，他们可能都有他们自己的目的，他们有时看来好像投你所好，是你很难去琢磨的，对不对？他们也不会真心待你的，他们的伪装，他们之所以伪装，是因为他们怕你，因为你所要的是权势。
Dear friends, if you fall under this category, perhaps you do not have any true friend, and you are locked up in your loneliness, and even those who approach you, they might have an ulterior motive, and they try to take advantage of you.
那么还有一些人是什么？你的工作量，你可能工作狂，你可能是完美主义，你要把所有的工作做得很好，或者你真的是工作量这方面压住你，你负荷太重。
Who else bears the burden? It could be those who are working overly hard.
但有一些人呢，他们是真正的为求生存、求生活，他们有时也感觉到要养家，要扛这个家的一切的重担，所以他们是苦不堪言。
Then there are also those who are striving so hard to earn a better living, and they are really living a miserable life.
当然，有些人是面对了病痛。当病毒 COVID-19 来袭的时候，我们看到这一些病痛的人越来越多，还有一些人，我们是身体或者心灵，我们患病者，我们被压伤。
And of course, we also have the burden of sickness and the coronavirus, especially those who have been attacked by this corona.
弟兄姐妹们，你是不是感觉到工作很辛苦？你身负这个重担，你有时觉得衰竭，有时你很绝望，你觉得很疲倦。还有呢，你真的心力交瘁，你是不是这样的一个人
？Brothers and sisters in Christ.Are you really working so hard and just tired all the time? Are you bearing too much of a burden? Are you in despair? Are you just fatigued and you are anxious in your heart?
好消息是，这个和平之君、和平的主，他已经发出了邀请。他说，烦劳苦担重担的人，可以到我这里来，我就使你们得安息。
The good news is the Prince of Peace has given us an invitation that is to come to me, who is Jesus, all you who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest.
我们很感谢主，这位和平之君邀请我们来到他的面前，卸下我们所有的重担，让他来帮助我们，这样我们在他里面可以享受他给我们的安息。
And we thank the Lord that when we are able to lay down all our burdens before the Lord Jesus Christ, we can receive true and deep sound rest.
那万一句话说，我们怎样在我们现今的生活，面对这种种的挑战的当中，我们将去面对这些挑战，我们怎样安息在神的这个里面？其实很简单，就是接受耶稣基督的邀请，我们求神把他的安息置入在我们的心中，他能够满足我们一切的需要。
How are we to enter into that rest? The answer is so simple. All you have to do is just accept the invitation that Jesus Christ has given unto all of us and receive the peace and the rest into our hearts.
那我要提醒你一下，你必须要放弃任何依靠其他的宗教的外壳寻求的真理，或者这些教条，那它不能够帮助你的。
And we need to let go of whatever dependence that we are relying on, especially on other religious or occultic beliefs.
还有要提醒你一下，不是靠你自己的思想。当然，外面有很多的这些心理学的训练，要我们培训起来更自己。但我要讲的是，不是那种绝对自己的思想，而是单纯的依靠他，相信他。
May I remind you, this is not to train yourself to only depend on positive thinking alone, but by simply trusting the Lord.
那如果今天你在听这边道理的时候，其实你是宗教这方面的啊，你是宗教的问题，那我就要劝你要放下你自己的努力，进入在耶稣基督的里面，享受他给你真正的平安跟安息。
And perhaps those of us who have the issue of religion or of faith, you need to lay down your hard work and your struggle and just choose to enter into the rest of Jesus Christ.
那这就是神学家所提的这个平安的救恩，或者说是称义的安息，在耶稣基督的里面，因为他是平安的主，和平之君，他可以给你平安的福音，跟上帝的关系和好，他可以给你称义，在神的面前称义，所以你不要再为你自己的这个罪恶操心，来到他面前，称义的福音会使你得到安息。
And like the theologians have said that we are to term this and call this the salvation of peace and the peace of justification. That when we receive salvation, there is a peace that comes alongside with it, that we are justified by Jesus Christ alone.
耶稣给我们什么样的应许？
So what kind of a promise that Jesus Christ has given unto us?
耶稣说，我留下平安给你们，我将我的平安赐给你们。我所赐的不像世人所赐的，你们心里不要忧愁，也不要胆怯。
Jesus said, My peace I leave with you, My peace I give you. I do not give to you as the world gives. Do not let your hearts be troubled and do not be afraid.
耶稣基督是现代人的希望。
Jesus Christ is the hope of today.
那我要读这几节的经文，让你们来看到，在约翰福音罢了，他就记载了至少有三次，他说：“愿你们平安。”
Let me read to you some scriptures taken from the book of John, and you will see that three times Jesus said that peace be with you.
那你们注意这个红色的字，我先念中文 ，Pastor Dorothy 念英文。
So, please take a look at the words that have been highlighted in red.
我们在家里的，我们一同来念好吗？
Shall we read together?
一二三，那日就是七日的第一日晚上，门徒所在的地方，因怕犹太人，门都关了。耶稣来站在当中，对他们说：“愿你们平安。”说了这话，就把手和肋旁指给他们看。门徒看见了，就喜乐了。耶稣又对他们说：“愿你们平安。父怎样差了我，我也照样差遣你们。”我们看英文的。
Let's take a look at the English. On the evening of that first day of the week, when the disciples were together with the doors locked for fear of the Jewish leaders, Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." After he said this, he showed them his hands and his side. The disciples were overjoyed when they saw the Lord. Again, Jesus said, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, I am sending you."
Amen.
Amen.
好，你看另外一个经文，我是念中文的。他说，过了八日，门徒又在屋里，多马也和他们同在，门都关了。耶稣来站在他们中当中说，愿你们平安。
Another portion of scripture tells us, a week later, his disciples were in the house again, and Thomas was with them. Though the doors were locked, Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you."
的确，亲爱的弟兄姐妹，亲爱的朋友，在我们的生活当中是充满了许多的挑战，尤其是现在，充满了许多的焦虑、恐惧，很多的事情都是这些东西所带来的。中国人有一句话说，人无远虑，必有近忧。然而我们感谢主耶稣基督的恩典，他是我们的盼望，因为他本身就是和平之君，是平安的主。
Truly, our everyday lives can be filled with a lot of fear and anxiety. And even the Chinese saying, there is a Chinese saying that says, even if you don't have a worry that is far away, you will have some anxiety of some sort that is just near to your heart. But Jesus is saying that he is the Prince of Peace. He is the one who has given us peace.
让我们接受耶稣基督的邀请，进入他的里面，把我们各种的重担卸下给他，让他来帮助我们。
Let us accept the invitation of our Prince of Peace, that we will let go of our burdens and follow him.
那我们怎样能够得到安息跟平安呢？
How are we to receive 安息 and 平安, which is peace?
那刚才我们刚才我们已经说了哈，我们要接受。那最后一点，和平之君他邀请我们，其实我们还是要顺服，像他一样顺服上帝，并且服侍的。
How are we to do so? It is through our obedience and through our commitment to serve.
你知道这个牛妇的这个恶，恶的目的啊，恶的这个目的其实是要减轻搬重货物的不舒服感。
Now the purpose of the yoke is intended for the cow to be eased from the burden or from the discomfort in carrying a heavy load.
我们再看这个经文一下。
So let us take a look again at the scripture.
他说，我心里柔和谦卑，你们当负我的轭，学我的样式，这样你们心里就必得享安息。
Jesus said, "Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls."
弟兄姐妹们，你们看到了吗？其实这里并不是说我们没有我们当父的这个责任的哦。我们从耶稣的这三节经文的里面，给我们看到的是，我们跟从主的人还是有我们的责任，还是有我们的负担要负担的，还是有我们的使命我们要当的。为什么？因为他是说，你们当负我的轭，而且是谦卑顺服，学习他的样子来负每一个人自己的轭的。
When we let go of our burdens, it doesn't mean that we are relieved from all our responsibilities. But more so, when you look into this verse, it tells us that we are to take the yoke of Jesus upon us. The taking the yoke of Jesus is not the only instruction here, but we are to learn from him. And therefore, we are to be committed in doing so.
那显然的，我们是有轭要负的，意思是说，其实在我们生活的当中，我们还是要负起我们的责任的。我们当扛起我们自己的这个责任跟生活当中的任务。然而我们第一点该已经说了，是要把这些东西先交给他，然后我们操练主的样式，谦卑到他的面前来服侍上帝。
So from our day-to-day lives, we are still to bear the responsibility that we are to learn and practice from our Lord Jesus Christ how to be humble, how to be gentle in heart, just like how he has obeyed the Lord.
他说我的心里柔和谦卑，你看他顺服天父上帝的旨意吗？所以我们也必须要谦卑顺服来到神的面前，我们不但相信他，我们敬拜他，我们要服侍他，我们也要靠着圣灵上帝的帮助来担起我们生活当中当负的这一个责任。
So similarly, with the help of the Holy Spirit, we are to obey and to follow Christ's example when we worship God the Father.
哦，耶稣说了，请你们放心哈，耶稣说了，因为你不要担你自己的轭。意思是说，你要把这个你自己，可能是来自你自己社会，或者是你自己思想造成很多很多的重担。他说，你不要把这些卸给我。然后呢，来担我为你预备的。他说，因为我的轭是容易的，我的担子是轻省的。
Why do we do so? It is because Jesus has said, "My yoke is easy and my burden is light."
好，你看这个轭，这个轭哈，我们知道了，这是牛背上的轭，是为了拉车，是为服务用的。主的轭是轻省的轭。主的担子也是轻省的。
When we know that the cow, when he actually take upon the yoke, that is to actually pull a heavy cart that is behind him. But when we take on upon the yoke of Christ, it is light and the burden is easy to bear.
当我们把我们自己在生活当中自己加添种种的压力，不正确的思维，不正确的思想等等的东西加重我们自己负的轭的时候，这里耶稣已经邀请你，让他来为你安排你当负的责任。
When we allow wrong thoughts to actually come and add burden to our heavy load, this will cause us to be burdensome and troubled in our hearts.
你知道吗？一个牛所负的轭，它大小啊，必须是要适中的，否则它在活动的时候，当牛在拉车的时候，活动的时候会擦破牛的皮。我们每次说牛皮，牛皮什么意思？牛的皮是很厚的，牛的皮是很粗的，但是不适当的也会使到这个牛受伤。
But when we talk about the yoke that is placed upon the cow or the herd, we have to make sure it is the right size. Because if it's too small, it's going to hurt and it's going to scratch upon the skin of the cow and it will hurt the skin.
那你可以想想一下吗？在你生活当中，可能你我刚已经说了，有一些的东西是你不需要承担的。每一个人对生活要负责，但是你负面的思想，你消极的思想，你悲观的思想，还有各方面的影响，你已经负了很多，是不必要的担心，不必要的轭。
So what are the unnecessary load or the burden in life that you have taken upon yourselves? Could it be your negative thoughts, your pessimistic views of life, the things that you keep worrying? All these add on to the burden that is unnecessary.
你看，如果你拿500公斤的东西直接放在牛的背上让它去扛，它会觉得辛苦的。
Now, if you put on a 500 kilograms of heavy load upon the cow, it's going to be really hard for the cow to move.
但是当一个适当的轭给它拉车的时候，在拉后面重担的车的时候，它就会觉得轻省的。
But if there is a suitable yoke that is placed upon this cow, then he's able to pull this yoke a little more easily.
所以一个适当的轭可以减轻我们的负荷。
So a fitting yoke is able to reduce that burden we are carrying.
容易这个字，容易这个字，因为耶稣说，因为我的轭是容易的，我的担子是轻省的。容易这个字在原文是 chastos， 意思是说十分适合的，是很适合你的。
Yeah, when you look into the original word for the word easy in the Greek word, it means very fitting, very suitable.
那么这个经文很清楚告诉我们，耶稣基督量给我们生活的责任，给我们的责任是轻省的。这个任务，这个轭是为你量身定制、量身定做的。
This scripture reminds us that the yoke that Jesus gave unto us is actually tailor-made for you.
是很适合你来扛的， 不会太重，也不会太轻，是刚刚好的。
It's suitable for you to carry because it is just right fitting in size.
他也盼你同行，他也盼着你走这条路，你可以轻易扛啊扛得起的。
And he walks alongside with you, and this burden is easy to carry.
弟兄姐妹们，不论你的这个轭是从哪里来的，这个负担从哪里来的，让我告诉你，神不会把一些你自己不能够承担的东西加诸在他所爱的子女的身上。
Brothers and sisters in Christ, God is not going to add upon the heavy load that you are already carrying unnecessarily.
Amen.
Amen.
让我们安静在神的面前来读这个经文。
When let us be still before the Lord and read this scripture.
因为我们的大祭司并非不能体谢我们的软弱，他也曾凡事受过试探，与我们一样，只是他没有犯罪。
Amen. Let us read together this scripture. For we do not have a high priest who is unable to empathize with our weaknesses, but we have one who has been tempted in every way, just as we are, yet he did not sin.
还有，我们要把那些不应当是、不应该是由我们来扛的这一些重担卸给耶稣。
We need to let go of all the burden that is not for us to bear and give it to Jesus.
我们大声来宣告。
Let us proclaim loud.
圣经说，你们要将一切的忧虑显给神，因为他顾念你们。
Let us proclaim together, cast all your anxiety on him, because he cares for you.
弟兄姐妹们，我们来到这个总结了。
Brothers and sisters in Christ, in closing,
当我们面对我们人生种种的挑战的时候，尤其是我们现在这个非常的时期，我们当怎么做？或者我们为罪所困，或者我们为做生存，我们为生活求存，或者因为我们孩子的问题，或者我们夫妻的关系紧绷，或者 COVID-19 当前，还有我们面对看来好像很难处理的这个病痛，我们应当怎么做？
When we face so many challenges in life, how are we to respond? What are we supposed to do? Are we in this bondage of sin? Are we striving just for a better living? Are we facing our problems with children, where you have also tension between husband and wife relationship with the current COVID-19 cases that is arising? How are we to react?
那我想牧师要告诉大家的，就是我们要来到他的跟前，我们都是劳苦担重担的人，我们就接受他的邀请吧，到他的面前亲近他，求助于他。
Brothers and sisters in Christ, we who are heavy laden and burdensome, let us accept his invitation, come before him, draw near to him and ask help from him.
第二，你要知道他知道你的问题。
Secondly, you need to know that God knows our problem.
他是你的造物主。
He is our creator.
圣经这里告诉我们说，他心里柔和谦卑，他是蛮有怜悯的神，他知道我们能够承担的有多少，他也知道我们的能力到底有多大。
The Bible tells us that Jesus is gentle and meek in heart. He is full of mercy and compassion. He knows exactly how much we can bear. He knows our capacity.
当然，牧师要提醒大家一下，切记，每一个人在你日常生活的当中，恩典是白白赐给我们的，我们还是有本分当尽的，我们对我们的生活还是要扛起我们的责任的。
I must say this, that you need to remember, even though grace has been freely given unto us, we still need to bear our own responsibility.
那很重要的这一点，就是他为我们的生活预备，是最适合我们的轭，是为你为我量身定做的轭，因为我们是他造的，我们肺腑也是他造的，在诗篇139篇讲得很清楚了，在母腹中你已经护庇我。对我们的一切的一切了如指掌，连我们的思想所思所想他都知道，到底你的能耐有多大他也知道，因此他为给我们生活中担负的这个责任不多也不少，这个是耶稣基督他给你的轭。
Most importantly, God has provided the best yoke for us that is tailor-made just for you and me. Because we are His creation. Our inward parts He has formed. Even in our mother's womb, God has already chosen us and covered us. God has already known us from inside out. He knows our thoughts. He knows our ways, even as written in Psalm 139. He knows how much we can bear and endure.
Amen.
And the things that He has given unto us is not too much, it's not too little.
Hallelujah. 弟兄姐妹们，这一点非常重要，记得记得记得，你现在扛了很多的轭，过重了，让你把这个轭卸下，放在神的面前，你有责任当尽吗？有，那是耶稣 为你预备一个轭，这个生活中的轭是最适合你来担的。
Brothers and sisters in Christ, what is the yoke that you are carrying right now? Be yoked together with Christ, whereby you no longer carry it by yourself.
让我们好像耶稣一样，学像耶稣的谦卑，回应天父上帝的邀请。我们顺服天父，在我们日常生活的当中，荣耀我们天父的圣名。
Let us submit to God the Father, and let us be obedient and humble, and glorify His name.
我们大声来念这个经文。
Shall we read this scripture aloud together?
耶稣又对众人说，若有人要跟从我，就当舍己，天天背起他的十字架来跟从我。
Then Jesus said to the multitude, to them all, whoever wants to be my disciple must deny themselves and take up their cross daily and follow me.
弟兄姐妹们，我相信今天的信息，神会对一些人说话。
Brothers and sisters in Christ, I believe God is speaking to some of us.
你把你各种各样的问题带到神的面前。
Bring all of your problems to the Lord.
你要把一些是你不需要扛的，你不需要负责任的，完全交托给神。
Bring your yoke and the burdens that you are not supposed to bear, bring it before Christ.
你必须奉主的名求圣灵上帝清楚给你指示，你生活当中你该做的是什么。
And in the name of the Lord Jesus, ask the help of the Holy Spirit to teach us what to do in our everyday lives.
来到神的面前，相信神，顺服神，并且把你的一切的问题交托给他。
Come before God, submit yourself to Him and be obedient, whereby you follow His ways.
在日常生活当中，不管是在哪里，不管你是怎样的境况，让你操练神跟你同在，你要负主给你所负的轭。
It doesn't matter what circumstance you are in right now. Remember, God is with us and God is for us.
学他谦卑的样式，谦卑的来到神的面前求帮助。
Learn from Him who is meek and gentle in heart. Ask help from the Lord.
我再说一次，负主为你预备的轭。
I say this one once more, that God the Father who has prepared that yoke.
因为他的轭是容易的。他的担子是轻省的。
That yoke that is provided for you is easy, and His burden is light to bear.
愿上帝祝福大家。
May God bless all of you.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, 牧师带给我们一篇非常鼓励和安慰的信息。担子会过重吗？神所为我们预备的担子是量身定造的，是配合我们所能承担的给予我们的。让我们带着一颗安息安静的心，来用这首诗歌来回应他对我们的爱，求神把我们藏在他的翅膀荫下，在他的大能手中，求神保护我们，因为他是我们的神。
藏我在翅膀荫下，遮盖我在你大能手中，但大海翻腾，波涛汹涌。 拥有，我与你展翅高峰升空，负你人作万在洪水中，我要安静知你是神，我要安静知你是神。
神是我们的神，大家平安。现在是报告时间，让我为大家报告几项的事项。第一，就是我们的奉献方式依然是用 Touch and Go、 Maybank QR Pay 和 Online Banking。 For your information, you may give your offering through Touch and Go, QR Pay or Online Banking。还有来临星期四晚上八点半我们会有祷告会，所以鼓励弟兄姊妹们参与。 For coming Thursday, we having our online prayer meeting. Hope all of you can join us. And 接下来就是马来西亚华人联谊会成年团去举办了这个一中同行健康讲座，如果有兴趣的弟兄姊妹们可以向成年团去来了解更多的详情。然后这一个健康固本已经在教会当中办公室，如果有需要的可以来购买。报告的最后，让我们一起来看一看社会关怀委员会金韩家庭事工的一个影片。
虽然道路崎岖，困难险阻，心中知道你一直都在，不能明白为何担此重担，但我始终相信你一直牵着我。大山为我们开，大海涌流出来，我要大声宣告在你受伤的 知道你一直都在，不能明白为何担此重担，但我始终相信你一直牵着我。
大山为我挪开，
为我挪开，
我要大声宣告，耶稣你一直都在。
很多朋友，我很喜欢补习，可以学好多东西。
我喜欢去教会，因为那边有许多好玩的活动，我在那边也交到了许多的朋友，而且那边的老师都很好，我在那边很开心。
教会的事可以认识到很多新朋友。
教会的原因是我喜欢那里的老师教我，而且那里的老师教我可以得到很多的知识。
今天去到教会很开心。
我家里的四个千金，在家里真的很潮啊，不是抢电视就是玩手机。教会我后来我知道教会有一个活动，我就给他们去。家里很太平，没有吵，回来呢就很高兴的去啊，很高兴的去，很有礼貌，没有再争吵一下。
你们喜不喜欢去教会？
喜欢啊！
我爱耶稣。
弟兄姐妹们，让我们预备心来领受圣餐。不论你在什么地方，是在你的家里，或者是房间里，或者是客厅里，请你带着你的家人一同站起来，带着一颗敬虔的心来领受圣餐。你们若真实悔罪，就当存信心前来到全能上帝的面前，谦虚的忏悔，领受圣餐，得受安慰。
我们一起用认罪文来祷告 ，The Prayer of Confession。无所不能的上帝，我主耶稣基督的父，创造万物、审判万人的主，现在我们承认及悔恨我们的种种罪恶，我们诚意忏悔，求慈悲的父怜悯我们，赦免我们从前的罪，又赐恩典，叫我们从今以后改过自新，尊主的圣意，这是靠主耶稣基督求的。阿门。请听圣经对谦卑懊悔的人所说的话。若有人犯罪，在父那里我们有一个中保，就是那义者耶稣基督，他为我们的罪做挽回祭。上帝爱世人，甚至将他的独生子赐给他们，叫一切信他的不至灭亡，反得永生。
主耶稣被卖的那一夜，拿起饼来，祝谢了，就掰开说：“你们拿着吃，这是我的身体，为你们舍的。你们应当如此行，为的是纪念我。”饭后，又拿起杯来祝谢了，递给他们说：“你们都要喝，这杯是我立新约的血，为你们和众人免罪流的。你们每逢喝的时候，要如此行，为的是纪念我。”阿们。
谦恭敬主恩，慈悲的主，我们来到主的圣座前，不敢靠自己的义，唯靠主的大恩典。我们就是拾取圣座下的零碎，也是不配的，唯主无永无更改，常施怜悯，叫我们能领受上帝爱子耶稣基督的圣体和宝血，使我们犯罪的身体和灵魂都可被他的宝血洗清，而获得丰富的生命。我们就常住在基督里面，基督也常住在我们里面。阿们。
我们请弟兄姐妹在家里做一个默祷，我们要做一个祷告。主啊，我们在你的面前，我们仰望你。主啊，我们都是你的仆人，谢谢你在创世以前为我们预备救赎的恩典，谢谢你借着圣子耶稣基督道成肉身降世为人，带来我们这个救赎的恩典。主啊，求你借着这个圣礼坚定我们对你的信仰，坚定我们对你的信心，奉靠耶稣的名祷告， Amen。请弟兄姐妹保持站立，我们要一同来领受圣餐。耶稣说，这个是我的身体，是为你们舍的，我们当如此行，为的是纪念我们的主。我们一同纪念我们的主。耶稣说，这是我立新约的血，是为你们免罪而流的，我们当存感恩的心领受。我们谢谢主的恩典。请大家保持肃立，我们请周传道带领我们做一个教牧的祷告。
我们一起祷告。天父上帝，谢谢你爱我们而赐下耶稣基督为我们死在十字架上，过后也赐下圣灵在我们当中。主要在我们生活中，我们有很多的挑战，很多的压力，但是透过今天的信息，你告诉了我们，你所给我们的恶是为我们量身定做的，不是超过我们所能够承担的。主啊，因着这样子的一个教导，我们深信在接下来的生活中，我们只要继续的依靠，抓紧你，顺服你，仰望你，我们的生命就能够在你的同在里面步入你所为我们预备的命定里面。主啊，我们期待你来在我们生命当中来做陶造，做建立的工作，帮助我们的生命越来越像你。每当我们领受圣餐的时候，让我们思念你在十字架上所为我们承担的，好让我们因着领受这一份无条件的爱，我们也愿意改变自己，为主背上十字架，走你要我们走的路。祝福我们每一个的人，让我们在领受圣餐的时候，生命也同时得到建造，得着盼望。谢谢天父与我们同在，祷告奉耶稣基督的圣名求，阿门。
弟兄姐妹们，我们仍旧保持肃立，领受上帝给我们的赐福。但愿我主耶稣基督的恩惠，天父上帝无比的慈爱，圣灵保卫师与我们每一个人同在，从这个时候直到永永远远，阿们。
感谢神，让我们有个美好的线上崇拜。我们线上崇拜就到此告一段落，我们下个星期再见。上帝祝福你，
阿门。